I don't know about the interpersonal relationships between Deshaun Watson and everybody with the Houston Texans. But I do know this. If you look at the Houston Texans' success while with Deshaun Watson, the 4 years that he's been there, they've made the playoffs twice. And if you look at the Houston Texans from 2011 to 2020, that is over this past decade, they are one of the most successful franchises in all of the NFL. In fact, most playoff berths from 2011 to 2020, I saw my buddy Paul Pabst, who's with the Dan Patrick Show, tweet out these totals, and it ties in with what I've been arguing for a while, all right? Which teams have made the playoffs the most over the last decade? Kind of a rough approximation of which teams have been the best run during that decade. Not a surprise, the Patriots made the playoffs 9 straight years until this season. I think everybody out there listening to us right now would probably say the Patriots had the best decade of any team in the NFL. They made 9 playoff runs. Up next, Packers. Pretty consistently good in Green Bay. They made the playoffs 8 of the past 10 years. The Seahawks. Russell Wilson, not awful. 8 of the past 10 years, the Seahawks made the playoffs. Then the Chiefs, who have been really good basically since Andy Reid got there, whether it was with Alex Smith or with Patrick Mahomes, the Chiefs have made the playoffs 7 times in the last decade. That's it for teams that have been more successful than the Texans. The Patriots, the Packers, the Seahawks, and the Chiefs. Only 4 NFL teams over the past decade have been better than the Houston Texans when it comes to making the playoffs. Tied with 6 appearances in the past decade, the Texans, the Ravens, the Saints, and the Steelers. All of those teams are really, really good. Far from being a franchise worthy of ridicule and a franchise worthy to demand that you be traded from, the Texans have actually been one of the top 25% most successful teams in the entirety of the NFL. One of the 8 most successful teams. And I bet a lot of you, because you don't really necessarily pay a lot of attention to the Texans, I bet a lot of you are surprised by that data point. Patriots, Packers, Seahawks, Chiefs, Texans, Ravens, Saints, and Steelers are the 8 most successful teams. And the Texans didn't just go to the playoffs. They won 4 playoff games there. Now, they haven't advanced to the AFC Championship game. They certainly haven't been to the Super Bowl. But this argument that somehow Deshaun Watson is wasting his career with the Houston Texans and they are so bad at running a football team that he shouldn't have to play there because of how bad they are. I mean, we're not talking about the Lions. We're not talking about the Bengals. We're talking about a team that is actually one of the best in the entirety of the NFL over the past 10 years and one that has had Deshaun Watson in the first 4 years of his career in the playoffs twice in the years that he could have gone. That's pretty doggone good, especially when you consider that one of those seasons, Deshaun Watson got injured and wasn't even able to finish the year. So for everybody out there that is on the, hey, the Texans are awful, no wonder Deshaun Watson wants to be traded, no wonder he doesn't want to stay with this team, the evidence doesn't actually support that that is true when you look and follow and track what is actually taking place in this discussion points. So that, I think, is worthy of being discussed. There are teams that are so bad, you could say, I'm done with them. You could even look and compare, let's say, James Harden to Deshaun Watson. We were just talking in the prior segment about all the different guys that have left Houston of late. As athletes, but you could also argue, hey, James Harden with the Texans, they had experienced the full length of where they were going to go. In other words, they had their chance to win championships. They now are trending down, and I can understand why James Harden would want out of Houston. You might not be happy with it, but you could understand, hey, they had their chance, the Rockets did. They didn't get it done. They couldn't hit any threes in the game seven when they needed to be able to find a way to get a victory. And so I think that was against the Warriors, if I remember correctly. And so you can understand why some guys might want out of the Rockets if you're a stud like James Harden is. But we really haven't hit a lot of bad years in a row. The Texans have had one bad year with Deshaun Watson, and in the context of the larger NFL universe, they've actually been wildly successful.